Hello, welcome back to anatomy classes. Today we shall learn about excretory system. So the case is about a 25-year-old man who came to a physician with the complaints of left side abdominal pain, and the pain is extending sharply from loin to groin, that is from the posterior side of the abdominal wall to anteriorly medial towards the inguinal ligament. So this radiating pain was increased periodically. So there was a mild reduction in urine output also. On examination, the abdomen was soft. So an X-ray was taken, where a plain X-ray anterior posterior view of abdominopelvic X-ray to view for any renal stones. So this X-ray is called as CUB X-ray, kidney, ureter, bladder, to view any stones in the kidney, ureter and bladder. In normal X-ray, these three structures, as they are soft organs, they won't be viewed in the X-ray. Only if there is any calcification like renal stones, we can view in this kind of X-ray. So here the man was diagnosed having renal stones. So we shall begin with the excretory system today. So the renal system comprises of two kidneys, a pair of kidneys, two ureters, a pair of ureters, and a urinary bladder. So kidneys are a very important excretory organs, and they excrete byproducts, waste products from the body, which are the byproducts of protein metabolism. Kidneys also maintain the electrolyte and water balance. And apart from excretion, the kidneys secrete renin, which regulate blood flow and blood pressure. It produces erythropoietin for maturation of RBCs. It also takes part in calcium metabolism. So these are the functions of the kidneys. Palpate the kidney. Palpability of a normal kidney in a normal built individual, the kidney is not palpable, but in lean individuals, we can palpate the kidney. The procedure to palpate the kidney is called as bimanual examination, where one hand is placed over the anterior abdominal wall and the other hand placed over the loin. And the pressure is exerted in a gentle pressure. During deep inspiration, we can the lower part of the kidney can be felt. So this examination is called as bimanual examination. There are two diagrams to show the anterior and posterior view of the kidney to mention its location. So anteriorly, the kidneys are located in the epigastric region, hypochondric region and lumbar region, and partly in the umbilical region. And right kidney, it is slightly placed lower when compared to its partner, because on the right side, liver is present, the large organ which push the right kidney down. And the long axis of the kidney, if we draw, the long axis present towards the lateral side, making the two lower poles away, and superior poles are near closer to each other. And the distance between the two hilum of the kidney is around 5 centimeters. And from the posteriorly, if we view, it is extending from thoracic to L3, that is L1, L2 and L3. So the lower poles are located at the level of L3 and superior poles are located at the level of T12. And as the right kidney is slightly lower, posteriorly it is related to 12th rib, and left kidney along with the 12th rib posteriorly it is also related to 11th rib. So because of the ribs and along the lateral border of the erector spinae muscle is the muscle which is present on the either side of the vertebral column, and along the lateral border of the erector spinae and the 12th rib makes an angle posteriorly which is called as renal angle, and medially the angle is present which is called as costovertebral angle, that is between the 12th rib and the vertebral line, lateral border of the vertebral line makes an angle called as costovertebral angle. So these angles are important clinically. So coming to the features of the kidney has got the upper pole which is called superior pole, lower pole which is called as the inferior pole. Superior pole is quite broader than the inferior pole because the superior pole is related to suprarenal gland, where the suprarenal gland lodges over the superior pole. Inferior pole is pointed and it has got the lateral border which is convex and medial border is concave having a notch which is called as hilum. And anterior surface of the kidney is convex and posterior surface of the kidney is flat. So these are the surfaces and poles of the kidneys. So let's see the relations of each. So if you see the shape of the kidney, it appears to be bean like shape and the length of the kidney is approximately 11 centimeters in length and breadth is 6 centimeters in breadth and the thickness is around 3 centimeters. Means 11 centimeters length, 6 centimeters wide and 3 centimeters thickness. And weight of the kidney, in males the kidneys are little heavier, they are it's around 150 to 170 grams and in females the kidney weighs around 135 to 150 grams in weight. And next we'll see the relations. The superior pole, as we know, it is broader and it lodges the suprarenal gland and inferior pole is pointed. The inferior pole lies 2.5 centimeters above the iliac crest. And medially, the hilum is related to three important structures: renal vein, renal artery, and renal pelvis. Renal pelvis continues down as the ureter. Renal pelvis is the upper part of the ureter. It is a funnel, broad-shaped structure, and it arises below the renal artery. This is the renal pelvis. Till it is called as renal pelvis till the lower pole of the kidney. Beyond the lower pole, it is called as ureter. So ureter goes down and conveys the urine into the urinary bladder. So anterior surface of the kidney, if we see the relations from above, both are different anteriorly because the abdominal organs are different. So it medially, superiorly, it is related to suprarenal gland. And the right kidney, here is the right kidney. So right side liver is present, so its major part of the kidney is related to liver, which is called hepatic area. And along the hilum, the second part of duodenum is related. And here is the colic area, that is the hepatic flexure of colon. Next is the coils of small intestine, which is called as jejunal area. So these are the structures related to anterior surface of right kidney. So among these structures, the kidneys are retroperitoneal organs present behind the peritoneum, resting over the abdominal wall on the either side of the vertebral column. So the partly anterior surface is covered by peritoneum. So wherever it is related to liver, that is the hepatic area, colic area and jejunal area, these areas are covered by the peritoneum. And rest of the areas, that is the duodenal and suprarenal area, are devoid of peritoneum. Next we shall see about the left kidney anterior relations. Anteriorly, the left kidney is related to suprarenal gland and it is extends along the medial side also. Then here is the splenic area on superolaterally. Then gastric area, where stomach is related, it is called gastric area. And this is the pancreatic area, and below the pancreatic area we have got the jejunal area, that is the coils of small intestine. Then colic area, here the splenic flexure of colon is related to colic area. So among these areas on the left side, whichever the areas are covered by the peritoneum, that is the splenic area is covered by the peritoneum, gastric area is covered by the peritoneum, and jejunal area are covered by the peritoneum. Rest of the areas are devoid of peritoneum. So that is about the peritoneal relations of left kidney. Posterior relations of the kidney on the right and the left are all same, except there are few differences. So first, the relations of the right kidney. The right kidney is slightly lower. So from above, it is related to the 12th rib and it is related to the right dome of diaphragm. And diaphragm ends by forming two ligaments which are called as medial arcuate ligament and lateral arcuate ligaments, which gives partly origin to the diaphragm. And below the diaphragm, from medial to lateral, the most medial most relation is the muscle which is called as psoas major muscle, which is covered by a fascia called as psoas fascia. And little lateral to the psoas major, there is a muscle called as quadratus lumborum. Here is the quadratus lumborum muscle. The quadratus lumborum muscle is covered by a fascia which is thoracolumbar fascia. So the anterior layer of thoracolumbar fascia and quadratus lumborum are related in the middle part of the kidney. The lateral most part of the kidney is related to transversus abdominis muscle, which is covered by fascia transversalis. So these are the muscles related. Next we shall see the blood vessels and nerves. Next to the, just below the lateral arcuate ligament, below the lateral arcuate ligament of the diaphragm, we can see the vessels and nerves coming out, which are called as subcostal vessels and nerve, which are subcostal vein, subcostal artery and subcostal nerve. And the next nerve which comes out between the psoas major and quadratus lumborum, the nerve here is called as iliohypogastric nerve. And below in the lowermost part, there is an another nerve which is coming out, which is called as ilioinguinal nerve. So these are the nerves which are related from above onwards: subcostal vessels and nerve, iliohypogastric, ilioinguinal. So what is the difference between the posterior relations of right and left? On the right side, it is present little lower, so it is related to 12th rib. On the left side, it is little higher, so it is also related to the 11th rib posteriorly. So that is the only difference between the right and left posterior relations. Next, we shall see about the coverings of the kidney. So the coverings of the kidney, the first covering which attaches along the kidney is called as the fibrous capsule. The fibrous capsule intimately attaches to the kidney and it is formed by the condensation of connective tissue of the kidney itself. So the condensation of the stroma forms the capsule, which is called as fibrous capsule. And this fibrous capsule in a healthy kidney, we can easily strip off. Just like an onion peel, we can strip off. But if it is a diseased kidney, this fibrous capsule is adherent to the kidney where you cannot remove it. Next to the fibrous capsule, there is a thin layer of fat or adipose tissue which is called as perirenal fat. This is the perirenal fat. So perirenal fat, if you see, it is more abundant on the lateral and the medial side of the kidney compared to anterior and posterior surface of the kidney. So that is about perirenal. Outer to perirenal fat, there is a fascia which is formed from the surrounding muscles, which is the condensation of extra peritoneal connective tissue, which is called as renal fascia. So we shall trace the renal fascia now. The renal fascia, this is the transverse cut section. Here is the vertical section or sagittal section. So renal fascia has got the anterior layer and posterior layer, and laterally the renal fascia continues with the fascia transversalis, which is covering the lateral most part of the kidney, that is a muscle. Transversus abdominis is covered by fascia transversalis. So the renal fascia continues laterally as fascia transversalis. And when it comes to the lateral border of the kidney, it splits into two layers, anterior layer and posterior layer. The anterior layer of renal fascia is called as fascia of Jarota. The anterior layer is called as fascia of Jarota, and the posterior layer is called as fascia of Zeckerkandel. And the anteriorly, if we trace the fascia of Jarota, it is continuous with the great vessels which are present medial to the kidney, that is aorta and inferior vena cava. So it continues in front of the aorta and inferior vena cava, and it also lines in front of the renal vessels, and it fuses with the opposite side of the anterior layer, which is present on the opposite side of the kidney. Then the posterior layer it blends with the fascia of the muscles, which is present in front of psoas major and quadratus lumborum, that is the psoas fascia and anterior layer of thoracolumbar fascia. Further, it continues laterally, fusing with the anterior layer to form fascia transversalis. So in vertical disposition, we can trace above and below. So this is the anterior layer of renal fascia, which is called fascia of Jarota. The posterior layer, which is related to posterior abdominal wall, is called the posterior layer, which is called fascia of Jekerkhandel. Superiorly, these two fascia, they join to with each other. They will join with each other. Again, the two will split to form a separate compartment. Further superiorly, if we trace, they will join back again and they get reflected along the diaphragm. So, inferior surface of the diaphragm. So, the connection between above to the diaphragm, the reflection is called as suspensory ligament of suprarenal gland. So, superiorly, the gland is the suprarenal gland, which is present in separate compartment above to the kidneys. So, that is the reason when kidney sinks down in moving kidney, the suprarenal gland doesn't descend along with the kidney. They remain in its position because of this suspensory ligament of suprarenal gland. That is about the superior disposition of fascia. And inferiorly, if we trace the fascia, inferiorly the two layers are separate and they blend with the extra peritoneal tissue. Further, they continue to form fascia iliaca, which is present on the inferior side of the abdomen. Fascia. Outer to the renal fascia, there is a variable amount of fat which is called as pararenal fat. This is called as pararenal fat. The pararenal fat is more abundant on the posterior surface of the kidney than the anterior side, and it acts like a cushion for the kidney, like a bed, and keeping the kidneys in position. So that is about the pararenal fat. So we shall just revise once. It has got four layers. The innermost is the fibrous capsule, which is like a thin layer formed from the condensation of connective tissue of kidney itself. Next is the perirenal fat. Perirenal fat is a thin layer of adipose tissue present along the kidney, and it is more abundant on the lateral and medial side, filling up the renal sinuses. Next is the renal fascia. The renal fascia is the condensation of extra peritoneal connective tissue, and it has got two layers, anterior layer and posterior layer. And the outermost is the pararenal fat, which is more abundant on the posterior inferior part of the kidneys, forming a cushion or bed for the kidney and keeping the kidneys in position. So that is about the coverings of kidneys. So today we have learnt about location, relations, coverings and external features of the kidney. Further, we shall continue with the internal features and blood supply and applied anatomy of kidneys. So I hope you all like my session. Please like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell button for further notifications. Bye.